Is Microsoft about to regain that number one spot in the internet browser stakes? Let's have a look. Welcome back, guys. As always, if you're new here, hit the subscribe button. Loads more things to come. If not, let's get on with it. So a bit of a background. Edge was released with Windows 10 back in 2015, but it was poor. It was sluggish, really few extensions. It was pretty much unusable, especially if you stack it against Google Chrome and Firefox. Fast forward to December 2018, Microsoft admitted defeat and said they were going to rebuild Edge from the ground up. They were going to rebuild that with the open source code Chromium, developed by Google. And in the end, it was a bit of a masterstroke. When it was released in January this year, it was met with widespread approval. And the reason why it was met with approval is because it was a seamless transition. Now it's built on Chromium. It almost looks the same, but it has its own few little tricks, which I'm going to explain some of them in this video. Edge is already coming out on top on various features. It's got better privacy settings and stops more phishing sites than Google Chrome does, which is always a good thing. It's less resource hungry than Google Chrome. Chrome is known for hogging computer resources, which will slow your computer down. Edge uses less for a speedier experience. More and more people now are using touchscreen devices as their main PC, and Edge is miles better on touchscreen devices. And from what I've tested, it's better for video playback. Now, let's not forget, this is a Chrome browser, and when you switch, it all looks very much the same, it operates the same, but there's a few things that specific to Edge does better. I'm going to show you now my five top features of the new Microsoft Edge. The first thing, it's one of the first thing I use when I switch over because I find it really useful, especially since I started this YouTube channel now, is collections. Collections is a way to save websites into one category. And you don't have to just save your websites, you can save web images and text. And you save these and they're known as collections. They're shareable with other people. You can export them into an Excel file. It's a great idea. Okay, so I just wanted to show you how to use collections. So you'd open up your web pages, whichever one you want. We're just going to use some examples here from the Edge homepage. Let's go for this one. Now, web page opens up. You need to come to the end of the address bar where you find some icons. Now, the middle icon there, as you can see, like two squares with a plus in it. That's the collections icon. If you click on that. Now I've already got them saved, as I said in the video. I use it for collecting topics for some of my research for my YouTube videos. There's today's one. But to start a new one, start location, give it a name. And then you carry on search. If you find a web page you want, you just add to collection. Find another one. Yeah, that needs to go in there. So it adds a collection and you can just keep adding web pages. They'll go in. Now you don't just need to add web pages. If you find a picture you want to save, you can click and drag the picture. If there's some text you want to save, you can just go over here onto this icon here and it's add a note. Copy your text. Paste it in and they're all saved and they'll stay there so long as you keep your collections. Like I said, if you're booking a holiday, so you've got holiday destinations or maybe going visiting a city and you're looking at different places to visit, leave them in there. Once you've finished, you just tick on there and delete. What you can also do is on the collection, again, the three buttons, sharing and more, you click on them and you can export them. Open all so they're all open in a web tab if you had loads. Copy all, you send to Word, so this is a really good thing to do, is just stick it in Word and it just adds it to Word format. Hyperlinks to all the websites, it shows you the photos you've saved,
Shows you the text they saved. It even puts references in there. And there you go. That's just a Word document that you can save, stick in an email, and share it. Very good. Have a go yourself.
The next one I've started using quite a lot, actually, is turning web pages into apps. Seems a bit convoluted, really. Essentially, it's just one web page opening edge. What you can do is you get the option to turn it into an app. It puts it on the taskbar with its own icon. The first thing I did is open YouTube, convert to an app. Now I've got essentially a YouTube app on my taskbar that when it opens up, it takes away all the address bar and your favorites bar, and it opens up and looks like an app. It looks like an app, but all it's doing is running an edge. Quick and easy. Let me show you.
Okay, so I just wanted to quickly show you how to add a website as an app. So you get your website up. Again, I'm just showing you with YouTube. You'd come up to the settings, right over to the right hand side, the three dots. You come down to where it says apps. Manage apps if you've got more than one. But you'll get there, install this site as an app. And it's just a case of pressing that. That will show you the icon that will show. And you could rename it if you wanted to. You'd click on install and it would open as an app. What do I mean? Exactly that. It's opened as a web page, but it's took away all the top, so the tabs, the address bar, your favorite menu and everything. So it looks really clean. If you do need to open anything website wise that you would have a normal web page, click on the three dots. You've got your extensions, you've got all your normal menu items there. And the only last thing to do is if you want to access it quickly, is pin it to the taskbar. So now instead of coming down, opening up Edge, do is come down, it's pinned to the taskbar, click on that, and your YouTube app will open. And this can be done for any website. Try it out.
Now I've kind of cheated a little with number three because I've put two together, but I think they go hand in hand. So the first one is what's called Immersive Reader. Now it's a big bugbear of mine with some of the web pages that you visit, and it seems to pretty much be a lot of the news websites. They're just so full of adverts and pop-ups and little videos here and there that actually you just want to read the article. Well, in Edge now you can turn on what's called Immersive Viewer. It's not there for every website yet, but I'm sure that will come. And all you do is you click on the icon at the right hand edge of the URL, and it'll strip away all that's not necessary just so you can see what you come to read. Now the reason I put these two points together is because that icon to open up the Immersive Reader also opens up another feature which allows you to have a website read out aloud to you. Now this has obvious advantages for those with impaired sight, but it also allows you to listen to a web page. You don't have to sit down and scroll through it. You can carry on one of them, almost like a radio station. You just listen to that website, take on the key points, and if you're doing it for research, write them down, stop, go back. Very clever. Now the next one is actually quite simple in execution, but it does make a big difference. Now Chrome used to crash all the time, and what you'd have to do is close the whole window, even if it was just one tab that was running slow, which meant you lost a lot of work. Well, in Edge, it's got its own little built-in Windows task manager as such. You can close the problematic tab without having to close the on window. This feature also allows you to have a look which tab is using up the most memory and close them down. And the next one is actually what was the flaw with the original Edge. Its extensions or its add-ons were just, you just couldn't compare to Firefox and Chrome. But now this is built on Chromium. Not only have you got Microsoft add-ons, if you want to use them, but you can use all of Google Chrome's extensions. It's not set by default, you just have to go in and switch the setting to allow add-ons from other sources. But all your normal extensions that you use in Chrome are now available in Edge. And the bonus tip, you always get a bonus tip. There's a hidden game there. In the search bar, if you just type edge:// surf, there's a little game there called Let's Surf, a little surfer, move left to right, speed up, slow down, get power-ups, and see how you do. Maybe we'll start a little league in the comments. Switching browsers isn't for everyone. As long as you've got a browser you can access the internet, a lot of people are happy. that solves extra features that make browsers stand out from its competition. And this is somewhere where Edge is now excelling in that. So in conclusion, is it going to knock Chrome off top spot? Not for the foreseeable future, not for a long time at least. It may get into second place depending on which source you look at for market share. It's already moved into second and beat Firefox. Others are saying different. Whatever they say, it's certainly a massive improvement and it's just going to grow in popularity so long as they keep improving it as they're doing now. Guys, there's that many features that I wanted to talk about. I might do a part two in this because there's other ones that I believe will be beneficial to others. So if you do want a part two, let me know in the comments. Just put part two and we'll get that done. There you go. Have a look. Have a try. You can run Chrome and Edge side by side and see which one you prefer. Let me know how you get on. So I hope you found that useful. Food for thought. Would you move from Chrome over to Edge? Some people just can't do it. Some people just can't go to Microsoft. But we'll see. If you enjoyed that, just please give me a like. I'd love it if you can subscribe, which is up here. And here's another video if you want to keep on watching. For now, until next time, see you later, guys.